The pandemic has been hard on us all, but it has been particularly difficult on those who suffer from a rare disease, especially those that have an autoimmune or suppressed immune system. They and their families had to take so many precautions to stay safe during this time. Back in 2016, my former colleague, Representative Marcy Topol, and I began to talk about establishing a rare disease advisory council here in Pennsylvania. And when we talk about rare disease, you know, a particular disease in and of itself can be rare because it affects a relatively small number of people, but we all know someone with a rare disease because rare diseases overall affect 1 in 10 Pennsylvanians. So Representative Topol and I sponsored legislation to establish the council so that those 1 in 10 or 1.2 million Pennsylvanians could have a voice and an advocate that sees things through their lens. Because we don't know what it's like to care for a child with a rare disease or to be on the other end of a phone hoping that insurance will cover a therapy or a drug. After we sponsored the legislation, something rare happened. It passed with unanimous support and became Act 14 of 2017. The council, which includes patients, parents, advocates, doctors, nurses, representatives of pharma and insurers, advises the legislature and the governor about issues and policies that affect the rare community. It helps us see things through their lens. While this one day in February brings us here to shine a light on the rare disease community, we are committed on a bipartisan basis in working with the council to bring attention and awareness every day of the year to the needs of the 1.2 million Pennsylvanians with a rare disease. And as a legislator who will be leaving this body at the conclusion of my term this year, I want to observe that our highest calling in public service is to meet people where they are, understand their unique challenges and struggles, and use the levers of government to improve their lives. I believe that our work here and the work of the Rare Disease Advisory Council does just that.